Bhimasena, Arjuna, Nakula, Sahadeva, what calamity has befallen my brave brothers that they lie motionless on this harsh ground? Alas, this might be the punishment meted out to me for taking part in that inglorious game of dice. No ordinary being can ever defeat my invincible brothers. Whosoever you are, reveal yourself.
O Prince, know me to be the guardian yaksha of this pool. What I asked from each of your brothers were answers to the questions that I posed to them before they could quench their thirst. However, in their sheer impudence and arrogance, they refused to obey my command and have hence met their end. If you have even a slight sense of remorse for what mistakes your brothers have committed, then get ready to answer my barrage of questions.
I am ready, O Yaksha. Please ask, and I shall try to provide the answers to the best of my ability.
Wise decision. But remember, even if one answer is wrong, you will follow your brothers to Yamaloka. So here is the first question. Tell me, Ko Dik, which is the direction to look?
O Yaksha, it is not the mere earthly vision and direction of which you speak. It is the direction of thought that you refer to. Hence, Santodik, the way of saintly ones, is the way to look.
O Prince, then what is to be given up to become richer?
Desire is the root cause of poverty in man today. By giving up desire, man becomes wealthy and contented.
O Dharmaja, you see the sun's effulgence illumining the earth. What is it that equals the sun in its brightness?
It is Rutam, the absolute changeless truth that shines brighter than the sun. For the sun dispels only the mortal darkness, but truth dispels the darkness of ignorance, revealing the immortality.
Sadhu, Sadhu Yudhishthira, now tell me, what is it that sustains man more nobly than the earth itself?
Matra Devo Bhava, I bow down to the principle of motherhood that sustains man even before he sets foot on the earth.
Well done, O Prince. Now face the most difficult of them all. What is the greatest wonder in this world?
Every day, man sees others depart to the realm of death. Yet, he lives as if he is going to live forever.
I am mighty pleased with all your answers, O wise prince. Hence, I shall grant you a boon. You can choose one of your brothers and I shall bring him back to life.
All my brothers are equally dear to me. How can I choose one brother over another? Yet, if only one of them can be granted life, then, O Yaksha, please bring back to life my dear brother, Nakula.
Nakula? Strange choice indeed, O Dharmaja. You could have chosen Bhima, the one with the unlimited strength. Or Arjuna, the unparalleled archer who could be your shield in the impending war. Why did you choose Nakula, whose prowess is nowhere near that of Bhima or Arjuna?
O Yaksha, Dharma is my only shield, not Arjuna or Bhimasena. Dharma is my breath, my very being. I have two mothers, Mother Kunti and Mother Matri. Since I am the only surviving son of Mother Kunti, to keep the scales of Dharma equal, it is imperative that one of the sons of Mother Matri should also be alive. Hence,
I chose Nakula.
Dharmaja, Dharmo Rakshati Rakshitaha. The one who protects Dharma shall verily be protected by it. I will give back life, not just to Nakula, but all your remaining brothers. Arise, O Pandavas! Yudhishthira, I am Yamadharma himself, come in the guise of a yaksha and played all this drama just to test you. You have not just imbibed the essence of Dharma, but also applied it in every step of your life. History shall remember this day as that golden day when Dharma was made proud by Dharmaja. Vijayi Bhava, O Pandavas! Vijayi Bhava!